News 12 is brought to you by Kenneth Nugent. From the station that's on your side, News 12, first at 5, continues.
Good afternoon. It's a new federal report calling out shortcomings in the care of a local VA patient who died. Here it is right here, a report from the VA Office of Inspector General. It says in part, a patient went through a minimally invasive surgery here in Augusta, then died 13 days later in the intensive care unit while suffering alcohol withdrawal and declining health.
Our Sloan O'Cone joins us live from outside the VA now. So Sloan, what sort of problems did the report find with the care given to that patient? Well, the report looks at the care of the patient before and after the patient's surgery, and it found that the surgical team did all of their preoperative requirements correctly, but they happened to overlook the patient's overall poor health. And so they say that was a combination of failures between the surgical team, care providers, and the nurses. Before the surgery, the OIG determined the care provider failed to address the patient's poor nutrition. They had lost 27 pounds in 8 months, and they also failed to show them multiple abnormal blood tests, which they failed to communicate to the patient within the time they required to before the surgery. They didn't adequately address the abnormal chest images and failed to schedule and complete a barium swallow test. 2 days before the surgery, the patient reached out for help through a patient portal, complaining of being weak and unable to keep anything down. According to the report, the nurse who responded did not alert a care provider, call the patient, or suggest any other care. The report then goes on to say the provider's failures most likely contributed to the patient's poor health going into the surgery. Now, after the surgery, the report found the nurses did not correctly assess or treat the patient's alcohol withdrawal. They didn't give the patient the sedative the doctor ordered or monitor them correctly. The report says several of the nurses lacked the required training and competency to treat the withdrawal. They were also positioned incorrectly in their bed, which could have led to aspirations. The nurse stated it was to prevent the patient from trying to get out of the bed. Now, if you do want to read the rest of this report, we will have it posted on our website, WRDW.com. But all of this comes after years of investigations, miscommunications, and some preventable deaths. I'll have a story coming up on News 12 at 6 o'clock, diving deeper into the VA's checkered past.
Sloan, thank you for the live update there from Augusta's VA. Let's have a live look outside now.
That's Nugent. From the station that's on your side, this is News 12 at 6 o'clock.
First at 6 o'clock, a new report from the Office of the Inspector General sheds some light on the death of a patient at the Charlie Norwood VA.
This report comes from a health care inspection conducted after the patient died at the facility in Augusta, fall of 2020.
The patient was there for a minimally invasive surgery and died 13 days later. The OIG found a number of failures on behalf of the VA staff.
News 12 Sloan O'Cone spent the day digging into this 44-page report. She's live now outside the VA with details.
Well, the patient was in their 70s and had been receiving care from the VA since 1997. The report explains how the provider's failures most likely contributed to the patient's overall poor health going into the preoperative phase of care. Then several missteps were taken during that phase. And after the surgery, the nurses did not have the adequate training to care for the patient. But what the report goes on to mention are previous investigations since 2019 where a lot of the missteps overlap. Prior investigations cite issues with inefficient hiring processes, inadequate communication, non-compliant practices that contributed to, quote, adverse patient clinical outcomes, lack of consistent documentation, care deficiencies that likely contributed to a patient's death, and deficiencies in care coordination between facility staff and telemedicine ICU staff, which are similar issues in this most recent investigation. Before the surgery, the OIG determined the care provider failed to address the patient's poor nutrition. They lost 27 pounds in 8 months, and multiple abnormal blood tests, which the VA failed to communicate to the patient within the time they required to before the surgery. They didn't adequately address the abnormal chest images and failed to schedule and complete a barium swallow test. 2 days before the surgery, the patient reached out for help through a patient portal, complaining of being weak and unable to keep anything down. According to the report, The nurse who responded did not alert a care provider, call the patient, or suggest any other care. The report goes on to say the provider's failures most likely contributed to the patient's poor health going into the surgery. Now, after the surgery, the report found the nurses did not correctly assess or treat the patient's alcohol withdrawal. They did not give the patient the sedative the doctor ordered or monitor them correctly. The report says several of the nurses lacked the required training and competency to treat the withdrawal. They were also positioned incorrectly that could lead to aspiration. The nurse stated it was to prevent the patient from trying to get out of the bed. And at the end of the report, the OIG did list off 10 different recommendations for the VA to ensure that something like this doesn't happen again. They recommended having proper alcohol withdrawal training, how to place patients in bed correctly, and just more control on getting patients those adequate levels of care. Now, the VA did send us a statement earlier today. It says, in part, Charlie Norwood VA Medical Center is dedicated to providing high-quality, compassionate care to our veterans. As a part of this commitment, Charlie Norwood VA Medical Center continues to implement new processes and the necessary quality reviews to ensure the veterans we are entrusted to serve receive the highest quality of care. They went on to say they have started implementing a lot of these recommendations, like the alcohol withdrawal training and same-day care. The full statement and report are on WRDW.com.
All right, thanks for that, Sloan. And for years, we have been tracking problems at the VA, including some colonoscopies that happened with dirty equipment. We have that for you on our website. And this really just the latest in a series of failures our I team has been investigating when it comes to local military families. Just a few weeks ago, I was in Washington, D.C.